Hi, how's your day going?
Very tired, I said, hungry. I couldn't even enjoy the beautiful day. It's out here, it's beautiful out here, but Kensington isn't that great.
So you're hungry?
Yeah.
All right, right after the interview, we'll get you a meal. Something of your choice.
Thank you. And it's funny, you know, even if I'm hungry, I'll still choose like the $10 before I eat. You know what I mean? Because of my addiction. It's so bad.
You'll rather have money before you eat?
Yes. I'd rather have money before I eat. 100%. Yeah. I will choose money over food any day. It doesn't matter how hungry I am.
So what's your name?
Penny. P-E-N-N-Y.
Penny?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, Penny.
Nice to meet you.
My name's Fox, ATM Fox.
Nice to meet you.
So where are you from, Penny?
Originally, I'm from Bucks County, Newtown. I don't know if you guys are familiar with that area.
Yeah.
But it's like outside of Philadelphia, about 40 minutes, I guess.
Okay.
And, I don't know. When I was 18. My friends, hey, this is a great place, Kensington. You know, I'll take you down. It's just a big game, you know. Friends driving down and they're, you know, it's cars. You know, I didn't know that you get sick from dope. It sounds crazy, but I didn't. I didn't know anything about drugs. I never saw row houses, you know. That's not an excuse, you know what I mean? I'm just saying what happened. Came down here, started using heroin, and that was 22 years later.
22 years later, yeah. In 2000 you started using?
Technically it was like 99, but yeah.
And you said your friends just introduced you at 18?
Yeah, I guess it was the older people that maybe had a little, with the oxys that came out. I never did an oxy, never did a perk. I came down here and it was like fun, you know what I mean? Driving down 95, coming to like that area, you know what I mean? I didn't understand anything about this and what will happen, and that sometimes once you use once, that's it, you will never leave.
Okay, Penny, you know. Understand. Let's take it back. How was your life like before drugs?
I used to play soccer, field hockey. I rode horses, I was in school, still have 60 credits left to pay dental hygienist. I've gone back to school so many times.
Okay.
Had, you know, some cars before, apartment.
Yeah.
I had a nice life, a normal nice life.
You had an apartment So you had an apartment?
Yeah, I had an apartment, and then, I thought it would be a good idea for school to go and to make money. I started dancing. So once I started dancing, I was going to be for school. But after making that money for dancing for school, I quit school within like, I don't know, 10 months. So that didn't last. But I did, you know, stay dancing up to like 15
years. When you were dancing, were you using it all?
Yes. Yeah. And that's, I got fired a lot. Because I couldn't keep the tracks on my arms hidden. Now I can't even go on my arms anymore. They're all gone. I have to go on my neck because I don't have anything left in my arms. So that's like, you know, sucks. I always tell people the way like I was raised, you know, it's not about like, oh, you had morals or you had character, you know what I mean? It has nothing to do with that, you know. It's just it's a disease, genetics, you know, sometimes your personality and your environment, and all three things at one time. When I was about 15 to 18 combined and I started using drugs, I had a depression stuff. I used to cut myself, so that's what started it, to numb. And then I started using the drugs and that was like, oh my god, where have you been all my life? This is what I need. Never felt like I felt right side my skin, felt different from everybody, never belonged, just always felt very uncomfortable. The drugs took all that away, until they didn't.
You seem like a very smart woman, Penny.
Thank you.
You know, You seem like you understand your trials and tribulations.
When I was 18, 19, my parents would send me to nice rehabs, West Palm Beach. Beautiful, you know, from the ocean. Again, I still thought it was a joke. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I still didn't get it. I mean, too, as 18, 19, 20, you still think you're invincible. You still don't understand, you know? Now, I went to Kensington Hospital, you know, whatever, wherever I could get in, you know. Sometimes there's 15 people in a room, you know, it's bad. But, you know, I had 2 years a year ago.
And, 2 years
Yeah, I had 2 years clean. Yeah. And I was really proud of that. And I just...
How were you living during these 2 years clean?
I was at the gym every morning. 3 to 4 days a week, I would volunteer for service. So there's a place down here called Cernelli House. They give out food, so I'd hand out food. Right. I worked in the donation closet and gave out food. I was there 4 days a week, you know, making sure I was giving back. And that helped me stay clean. Going to the gym, going to school, going back to school again. I got a car, got an apartment.
Right.
You know, life. Enjoyed life. I traveled again, you know, and then picked it up. And then I don't know how your mind tells you that this time, I'm just going to use this one time, you know, it'll be all right. I have this, and this now. I saved $15,000, you know, to go and travel. I always want to go out of the country.
$15,000?
No, I spent it all on drugs. As soon as I relapsed, it all went, every cent. And when I was sober, I saved all of that money. I saved all that money because I got into Buddhism. I wanted to go to Bhutan and Thailand. And I saved all that up to travel.
Right.
I spent every cent on drugs. Every cent.
Now, can you elaborate for me? What was going through your mind that day?
Honestly, I was in and out of a relationship with somebody for like 7 years. For those 2 years that I got clean, he was out here using. So I, you know, send him boxers and stuff when he went to rehab, let him take a shower once in a while, but I kept my distance, you know. And I guess I got too comfortable. I thought I was not healed, but I could handle it. So I picked him up to help him, take him to laundry, help him do stuff when he was in a recovery house. All of a sudden, he was getting in my car and his eyes looked messed up. And I'm like, I know you're using. Come on. Let's go. So you always say you relapse, you know, mentally before you do physically, like pick up. So I probably I wasn't doing as much service work.
Right.
I started pulling back on giving out food and clothes to the other people down here.
Yeah.
I started going about more about me.
That's understandable.
Me.
That's understandable.
I mean? As soon as I started doing that, as soon as I start thinking about it's only me, I don't think about others, I end up picking up. I focus on myself and only myself, that's it. So, yeah, that was probably the first time I used them, though, was like little, that was probably the worst day of my life, because everything that happened, you know, like I always had really nice teeth, my chip got, my tooth got knocked out by somebody, I bit, you know what I mean, like just
out
everything
here?
That happened, yeah. Yeah.
That occurred out here?
Yeah. Been homeless out here, and I was able to get in a shelter, and from the shelter I was able to get a voucher. So I got a voucher and I got an apartment, so I'm like barely holding on to it. I was 2 months behind my rent. I know what it's hitting for. I've been down this road, you know what I mean? I mean, I know what it's hitting for. I'm just trying to do everything I can. I'm trying to go away, actually, to rehab.
You've been doing?
Yeah, I'm going to go try to make an appointment today.
Today?
Tomorrow.
Today,
yeah,
you should.
I am, actually, I am at Pat. It's
okay.
Up the street.
You're going to do that. We'll make sure you do that. Now, what's your life like? What do you go through out here? How do you make your money? How do you obtain?
I get money, you know, like you get like government money, you know, so I get that, you know, every month. And then too, my dad, he sends me money. He doesn't know that I relapse, so I depend on him a lot, like, it's just, it makes me, I don't even like saying it, like, it makes me sick. It was just my birthday. So my birthday, you know, he gave me money for my birthday. Every cent. Have to go, you know, and like, it makes me sick, like, you know.
Every cent.
Old, I'm sorry.
Every cent.
Every cent. And he's like older, you know what I mean?
How much did he give you?
$1,000, you know? And that money could have been spent on my rent, anything, anything, than just giving it, like, it just, it's sickening.
Right.
It really is.
Your father, he's wealthy?
No, I wouldn't, no, he's not, like, wealthy, but he's, like, always, like, helped me. Do you know what I mean? Like,
do you love your father?
I love my father very much. And that's another thing, when I was sober, I would call him every morning. We would talk on the phone every morning. And, you know, he's older and he's all alone. I should be there helping him. You know what I mean? He should not be sending his 40-year-old daughter money. You know what I mean? That's ridiculous. Right. That's straight ridiculous.
Have you ever worked the half to obtain your drug?
I did, like, from going into clubs, because I worked, Show and Tell, and Delilah's, and Escape, all the clubs around here. I've been to, like, everyone. I'll meet people in there, and they've been, like, really kind to me. Mm-hmm. Really, really kind, so I haven't had to...
You got your regulars?
Still? Yeah, yeah, like, I have these people that I've known for almost something like 6 years. And they've, you know, because they knew me when I wasn't using. They knew me using. They've taken me to rehab before.
Have you ever boosted?
No. I'd be the worst person for that. Yeah. I have when I was younger. When I was about 18 to 21. Used to be a big thing down here. We would boost in Bucks County or Delco. And then we'd bring them down to the bodegas and they'd buy, you know, everything. And then it kind of stopped because... I don't know, it was too many people, and I started again, but I'm not good at stealing. That's not my thing.
Do you have any children?
I do. He's 19. He's a great kid. He's going to school, college next year. We're friends, you know. I was there when he was younger. Okay. And then I came back in his life. Around 11, 12. I always wanted to be there, but his father wouldn't let me see him. His father kept me away from him. He would not let me. So I was always going to the courts to try to get visitation. And by this time, he's already 15 or 16. So they're just like, just call yourself, you know?
So when's the last time you talked to him?
I just talked to him 2 days ago. I gave him the keys to my apartment and I said, I'm leaving. I'm going away for treatment. Come with your girlfriend. Stay here. You know what I mean? I didn't tell him, you know, I'm behind 2 months rent. I don't want to put that on him. He's already had to deal with so much, you know. You just always told him growing up that I was sick. And I was in the hospital. Right. Just not well. Right. He never knew I was an alcoholic addict till recently. Or maybe he did, but I never said it.
And today's the day you go make that move.
Yeah, I'm going to this place. It's called PAD. It's right on Allegheny. And you can walk in there and you make an appointment for the next day. And the next day, you can get in rehab. So actually my friend just texted me and he said, when's your appointment? Like, when are we gonna do this? And I said, I'm going down today. Excuse me. I'm going down today and I'm gonna make my appointment. I mean, on top of it, I mentioned I'm on methadone. So okay. I was on 230 milligrams of methadone and still getting sick with this fentanyl. That's how strong it is. Yeah, so I'm on 230 methadone. Been doing at least, I don't know, like 5-8 bags of the fentanyl. And then I started using Xannies again.
Right.
So I picked up that habit. But they just cut me because I missed a couple days going to my clinic. So if you miss a couple days, they cut you. So I was just talking to my counselor from the clinic. She's like, okay, you don't leave tomorrow. You know, come there, sign your papers, and you could go. I said, all right, I'll make my appointment. Because, I know right where I'm at, it just keeps getting worse. Within another month, I will be all my bags on the street. Again, I've done that in the winter. And actually, Philadelphia is pretty good about handing out food to the homeless. Right. I remember Thanksgiving, I was out here living on the street. We had so many plates of food. we didn't know what, we couldn't eat at all.
Has anything traumatic ever happened to you out here?
Yeah, I mean, there's always traumatic things. You know, I've almost gotten raped. I did, like, it's just horrible stuff. I mean, it's blacked out in my mind.
Right.
Like, I seriously have no memory of it. Right. I know, like, the beginning, like, what happened, but I don't have any memory of what the person looked like or anything like that, you know. Just getting, you know, smacked in my face and, you know, a lot of guys, you know, down here, I'll just take all your shit if you don't give me it back. And, of course, they're going to fight back. So, you know, I've just gotten, like, smacked in my face, you know, for my stuff. And just a constant, like, you know, fighting, seeing other people dying. I just saw a girl the other day. Yeah.
Can you describe Kensington for me?
I would say it's like, some people say it's like a junkie playground, you know, because you could literally shoot heroin or crack in front of cops, and because it's such an epidemic, they can't lock you up anymore. It's just too much. That's why you see all the people sitting right out on the street in front of everybody shooting up, you know, in front of a cop, in front of people.
Right.
It's hell. I know a lot of people come here from different areas. It's an open market. You won't get in trouble, but once you get here, you'll never leave, and you will want to leave.
You'll be stuck.
I call it MIK, missing in Kensington. So many people come up to me and show me loved ones' pictures. Have you seen them? And I'm like, honestly, they're probably dead in a bando. I was living in a row house years and years ago, and the guy went to jail because a couple girls OD'd, and they took their bodies and they threw them in a row house. So he went to jail for that. And yeah, so if they find your body and they don't, just throw it.
Now, last question, Penny. What will you tell a 16, 17, 18-year-old out here ripping and running these streets in the same shoes as you, using these drugs?
Shit. People, like, when I went to rehab at 18 and 19 and 20 and now 40, all of it's just going to get worse, and you're going to get more beat up. From what I used to look like to now, it's sometimes people don't recognize me. You know, you're gonna lose your teeth. Everybody, you know, it's a fact. You will lose your teeth. You'll get fucked up. You'll end up with dentures. You'll get wrinkly skin for the women, you know, and for the men too. The men I see out here at 6'2", they're maybe a buck 20. You know, some of the things that the men have to do for money.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's just sad. It's really sad. And it's not like a one stop and I'll be out. This place sucks you in, I guess, because it is so easy. Not easy, but there's so many drugs. Do you know what I mean? And you can just sit there, but the life out here is, it's so hard. Yeah.
Penny.
Yeah.
You telling this story, you're saving someone's life. You know that, right?
I hope so. I hope somebody realizes, like, once you do it one time, you're fucked. Physically, the withdrawal, I cannot even describe. I'd rather die sometimes than deal with the physical withdrawal, how bad it is. Like, because people don't know about the physical part. That's why. I mean, I don't want to live like this, but the physical is so fucking bad.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Sickness.
Yeah, the sickness. Right. Yeah, so it's not just one time you walk away. Nope. You're stuck.
Next time I see you, Penny, I want to see you clean, all right? I'm going to get that update
with you.
Yeah,
you will. I'm going to make my appointment.
Don't just do it for you.
No.
Do it for everyone.
Yeah, I am.
Everyone in your corner.
Yeah. Yeah.
For your father. You know?
Yeah. And my mom.
Repay him with getting clean.
Yeah, I know.
That's repayment right there.
Yeah.
He'll love that. He'll love to see his daughter again.
Yeah. So I finally go up and visit him.
Well, thank you for your time, Penny.
Yeah.
You know you've been wonderful for me.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm going to pray for you.
Thank you.